Yeah. Toute gloire au dévot assemblé. Qu'est-ce que c'est? Je parle français. Tu ne comprends pas, parce que tu es seulement un vieux knoll. Très bien en français.
Ah.
Oui, mais là. Oui. Je suis français. Tu m'as fait pour le. Anyway. Enough. See the jokes. We will start from there.
Sorry, isn't that stuff?
He doesn't speak Danish, no. And he doesn't speak Danish. This is an international society for Christian consciousness. So he's not in a dead house, he can't get a god. He's ready to not insist here. Because now I'm playing a French Danish game.
That sounds good.
Med borgerne er på engelsk. Det giver jeg altså ikke sådan noget overskridt. Det læser jeg sådan der.
Vil du gerne snakke ind i mikrofonen, fordi at, jeg har kun 80% hørelse.
Okay. Er det engelsk?
Ja.
Det er det. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Subsequent creation and the planetary system. in the third, fourth, and fifth cantos. Now, in this sixth canto, which consists of 19 chapters, he will describe posture or protection by the Lord, which is the fourth subject matter out of the 10 subject matters of the Bhagavatam, or for that matter, any Purana. That is the standard format of a Vedic Purana. It has to deal with these 10 subjects. The first chapter relates the history of Acharya, who was considered a greatly sinful man, but was liberated when four other carriers of Vishnu came to rescue him from the hands of the other carriers of Yamaraj. A full description of how he was liberated. Having been relieved of the reactions of his sinful life is given in this chapter. Sinful activities are painful, both in this life and in the next. You should know for certain that the cause of all painful life is sinful action. On the path of fruitful work, one certainly commits sinful activities, and therefore, according to the considerations of karma kanda, different types of atonement are recommended. Such methods of atonement, however, do not free one from ignorance, which is the root of sinful life. Consequently, one is prone to commit sinful activities even after atonement, which is therefore very inadequate for purification. On the path of speculative knowledge, one becomes free from sinful life by understanding things as they are. Therefore, the acquirement of speculative knowledge is also considered a method of atonement. By performing fruitful activities, one can become free from the actions of sinful life through austerity, penance, celibacy, control of the mind and senses, truthfulness, and the practice of mystic yoga. By awakening knowledge, one may also neutralize sinful reactions. Neither of these methods, however, can free one from the tendency to commit sinful activities. By bhakti yoga, one can completely avoid the tendency for sinful life. Other methods are not very feasible. Therefore, the Vedic literature concludes that devotional service is more important than the methods of karma kanda and jnana kanda. Only the path of devotional service is auspicious for everyone. Fruitive activities and speculative knowledge cannot independently liberate anyone, but devotional service, independent of karma and jnana, is so potent that one who has fixed his mind at the lotus feet of Krishna is guaranteed not to meet the Yamadutas, the other carriers of Yamaraj, even in dreams. To prove the strength of devotional service, Sukadeva Goswami described the history of Acharya. Acharya was a resident of Kanyakuja, the modern Kanauj. Kanauj, I don't know where that is. You know where it is? He was trained by his parents to become a perfect Brahmana by studying the Vedas and following the regular sutras. But because of his past, this youthful Brahmana was somehow attracted by a prostitute. And because of her association, he became most fallen and abandoned all regulative principles. Ajamil begot in the womb of the prostitute 10 sons, the last of whom was named Narayana. At the time of Ajamil's death, when the order carriers of Yamaraj came to take him, he loudly called the name Narayana in fear because he was attached to his youngest son. Thus, he remembered the original Narayana. Lord Vishnu. Although he did not chant the holy name of Narayana completely offensively, it entered nevertheless. As soon as he chanted the holy name of Narayana, the other carriers of Lord Vishnu immediately appeared on the scene. A discussion ensued between the other carriers of Lord Vishnu and those of Yamaraj, and by hearing that discussion, Ajamil was liberated. He could then understand the bad effects of fruitive duties, and could also understand how exalted is the process of devotional sex. So this is a summary of this very important chapter of the Bhagavad. Parikshit Maharaj had just heard the worst chapter of the Bhagavatam. All the worst, it's not just one chapter. So, there are several chapters in the first one describing the hellish planets. And he heard that he became most distressed and he became obsessed with the desire to understand how these sinful living and suffering and all these terrible hellish conditions, how they could be relieved from their sufferings. This is the nature of a devotee. He is perfectly okay himself, but he's not okay when he sees the condition of the suffering conditions, as exemplified by Prahlad Maharaj. My good TJ, Paradurajana, Vantanas, Padir, Kaila, said, I am very happy just always hearing about your wonderful activities. He was praying for Krishna. I have no problem, he said. Somebody else maybe. Hears about the life of Prahlad Maharaj, they may think, no problem. If you don't remember the story of Prahlad Maharaj, he was the son of the biggest demon in the universe, Hiranyakashipu. Practically from his birth, he was tortured by his father. He was just a little boy. His father, it's a long story, of course, but he was a great devotee, but he was intolerant, his mother. And because of that, ultimately his father, he tried to killed him in so many different ways. And, but I don't know how he tolerated all of that. Because he was always protected by the door. Therefore, he didn't even feel any pains, any tribulation. So that is the answer. How is it that he could stay like that? I'm very happy because he was fully protected by the Lord. Krishna says also Bhagavad Gita. And then it's Chinta Yantumam Yijana Paripasati Tisam Nityabhita Kshima Bhagavad. You just absorb yourself in thinking of me with love, worshipping me with full all your heart, and I will take care of yourself. I will carry everything you lack, I will preserve what you have. So in this way, devotees who are on that very high platform, yes, but attainable by each and every one of us also, they have not got there. And when you are on that platform that you have no problem, then you develop the ability to think of others. If we are suffering too much ourselves, how we will think of the welfare of others? At the same time, it's also true that just by forcing ourselves to think about others, our suffering will also go away. Works both ways. It's not that we shall wait and I cannot think of anybody else because I'm suffering so much, so please help me first. Well, the remedy is also there, it's also the remedy for our suffering condition. To do it. It's we are not completely transcendental to the laws of nature, we're also suffering. Yes? Suffering sometimes? Or you're all happy? It's only me. It's a miserable condition. So, well, sometimes we feel not so happy. But the solution is actually to think of others. Of course, who are the others? The other. We should say, think of Krishna. First think of Krishna, but then also think of all of the other living entities, the other devotees, the other conditioned souls. Try to put yourself in their place and check how they look at them. See, how are they feeling? Are they happy? Are they sad? If they are feeling some problem, then think, what can I do to help? Of course, we should force ourselves to think like that. That can be done. If we understand this is the right mode of action, then we can adopt it. We can, like the scouts, they used to have a practice. They have to do one good deed every day. Usually the classical one, you help them some old person over the street, something. You feed the birds, something like that. One good deed you have to do. So of course you should do more than one good deed. You should try to make this our mode. To always try to think of others, try to make others happy, and we will find. And the wonder, the mysterious thing is that even just by trying to think like that, we will immediately become more happy, more peaceful. We will just forget. about that we were, you know, suffering and depressed, it makes us immediately happy. There's one of the Maharaj, he was told no story in here from the internet, read it 26 on the internet. It's about two people who were lying in hospital in bed next to each other, suffering terribly. As we do, the hospital is not a place for enjoyment, it's a place for suffering. So they were there, bedridden, none of them could, you know, move from the bed next to each other there. Misery lost company, so at least there were two that made it a little, some relief. Especially because one of them, there was on one side of the hospital room, there was a window. And that window was facing there was a garden there. There was like a park with a lake and people were strolling there. So the one who was next to the window, he was looking out and he was, you know, seeing these things. And he was describing it to his neighbor, who was not, because he was too far from the window, he couldn't see, he couldn't look out the window. But he was taking some pleasure, just hearing about it. Oh, every day he would ask the other one, what are you seeing outside the window? Tell me, describe, oh, it's a nice day, the sun is shining, and there's a, you know, a happy family, and you know, they're feeding the dogs and the children are playing and laughing. And it is so nice. And there are flowers. And this way he described. And this way his friend who was lying next to him, he was feeling so nice. So this would go on for some time. And then he died. That one who was lying close to the window, he died. So then the other one, who was next to him, he requested the nurse, please, could you move me to that bed? Could I take over his bed so I can lie next to the window, so I can look out and at least see something green, somehow normal people are happily enjoying their health. So they moved him next to the window so he could look out the window. And what did he see? Just the wall of the opposite building. There was nothing interesting to see. A very boring scene.